although we think of monsoons always as rains, it's not exactly a rain phenomenon. What happens is that the Indian Ocean and the Asian landmass, they get heated and cooled alternately over the year. Like in summer, the Asian landmass is very hot and the Indian Ocean is not that hot. So there is a land-sea temperature gradient which drives giant winds. And it just so happens that over India, the winds bring a lot of moisture and it starts raining. So that's why we look upon the monsoon as a rain phenomenon. And the monsoon over India is basically for 4 months, from June to September. So we get a lot of rain just 4 months in a year, and then we have to store the water for remaining 8 months of the year. And in fact, there are two monsoons. There's a southwest monsoon, there's a northeast monsoon. And the southwest monsoon season, when it is over, we get the northeast monsoon season, but that's over a small part of the country, usually over Tamil Nadu and the adjoining areas. So then the winds change and the rainfall is over another part of the country. So that's about the winds and the rains. We have on the northwest, we have the Rajasthan desert. In the extreme desert, it rains something like 10 centimeters in a year. Okay. While on the northeast, we have the wettest places on earth, like Cherrapunji and Mausinga, which are record breaking rainfall. We have something like 1100 centimeters in a year. Then we have the Western Ghats and the other places where it is about 300 to 400 centimeters in a year. So India has a lot of changing topography, and along with that the whole monsoon rainfall pattern changes from place to place. But that's something that we have to live with. I mean, you can't make a desert into a green patch all of a sudden. Nor would you like to deprive Cherrapunji of its rain. So making rainfall equitably distributed is in a sense a utopian idea. Because people have learned to live. I mean, a desert, people living in the desert are quite happy with their desert. You know, they live a colorful life. You see their dresses, the music. It's, they have got adjusted to it. They in fact take the summers in their stride. And when it rains a little bit more, the whole of Rajasthan gets in fact flooded. So it's not a simple thing that we just think of giving them more rain. There was a talk about interlinking rivers to connect the whole country, and then there is more rain. So theoretically, yes, if we interlink all the rivers, we can have an equitable distribution of rain. But scientifically speaking, it's a very difficult proposition. Technologically also, it's a very difficult thing to achieve, because you have to bring water from a lower level to a higher level on a, such a massive scale. So that is something which you can't really do so simply. So the best thing is to live with the water that nature gives us and be happy with it and conserve it and use it profitably. I mean, if you have less rain, make every drop of it. If you have more rain, also be thankful to God that you are getting that much of water and don't waste it. So it's not simply that we just equally redistribute all the rain, and people are not going to be happy because of that. So let's try to live with the culture that we have that has evolved along with nature. See, the monsoon basically, as I said, is a thermally induced phenomenon. I mean, when the landmass is getting heated up more in summer, the winds start blowing in one direction, and in the other part of the year they blow in the other direction. So if you have global warming, what is going to happen? The whole world is going to get warm. But if you see the global warming in its very fine structure, it's not uniform all over the globe. So there is more of warming on the land and less of warming on the oceans. Now, what means is that we are going to have a higher land-sea temperature gradient, which is good for a monsoon. So if you just take in a very broad sense, global warming will give a stronger monsoon. In the long run. But that doesn't mean that every monsoon is going to be strong, because the monsoon has its own natural variability. It doesn't rain the same amount every year. It doesn't rain the same place every year. It doesn't rain the same time every year. So all these things are apart from climate change. And most probably climate change is most likely to enhance the monsoon rainfall over India, which is good in the long run. The only thing is we don't really know because the models are not that reliable yet. They're not that accurate yet. So we really can't quantify how much will be the increase in rain because of climate change. Some people say it will be 3% in a year, 3% in 100 years, sorry, 3% over 100 years. Some people say it will be something like 18% over 100 years. So we have to just either have better models which can give us better information, or we have to wait and watch. But the only thing that we should be careful to understand here is that every little extreme thing happening should not be attributed as climate change. And if you have more rainfall in Mumbai on a certain day, it doesn't mean that Mumbai will have that rain every day, every year, henceforth. It's not going to be so. So extreme events are, apart from climate change, to be handled differently. But yes, there are effects of global warming on the monsoon which we should be aware of.